हरि ओम स्टार्ट द प्रेयर ओम समस्त जन कल्याणी निरतं करुणामयं नमामि चिन्मयं देवं सद्गुरुं ब्रह्म विद्वरं वसुदेव सुतं देवं कंसचानूरमर्दनं देवकी परमानंदं कृष्णं वंदे जगद्गुरुं त्वमेव माता च पिता त्वमेव त्वमेव बंधुश्च सखा त्वमेव त्वमेव विद्या द्रविडं त्वमेव त्वमेव सर्वं मम देव देव त्वमेव सर्वं गुरुदेव देव हरि ओम वी आर लुकिंग एट द मेडिटेशन श्लोकास ऑफ द विवेक चूडामणि दैट सेज ब्रह्म तत्वमसि भावयात्मनि सो हैविंग अंडरस्टूड इन टर्म्स ऑफ आई एम द टोटालिटी और तत्वमसि स्टेटमेंट और महावाक्य स्टेटमेंट कमिंग फ्रॉम द चांडोग्य उपनिषद the acharya here is gives a meditation slokas for us to contemplate using the knowledge that we have gained so far says we completed few slokas now we'll take up the sloka 259 janma vruddhi parinatcha pakshaya vyadhinashana vihinam avyayam janma vruddhi parinatcha pakshaya व्याधिनाशन विहीनमव्ययम् विश्वसृष्ट्यवन घातकारणम् विश्वसृष्ट्यवन घातकारणम् ब्रह्मतत्त्वमसि भावयात्मनि ब्रह्मतत्त्वमसि भावयात्मनि सो जन्म वृद्धि परिणति अपक्षय व्याधि नाशन विहीनमव्ययम् सो हियर वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट दि the birth so there are six modifications of this asti jayate vardhate viparinamate apakshyate and vinasyati so these are the modifications at the body level I am born such and such a date so who is born so body is born so I am occupying a body so scripture says that consciousness that jiva the subtle body enters into the gross body as is called the birth through the rains and through the food and so on of the process are described in the chandogya and there it says when does the life start people ask us when does the life start is it beginning of the birth no as the conception occurs it is essentially called samskara garbhadana samskara because the jiva now entering into that so that's what is called life once it starts into divisions you already have the life there as separate from the mother and that's what according to our scriptures also so therefore asti then jayate so asti that means it has come into that asti means the zygote has formed asti see that is the beginning of the life itself asti jayate vardhate so asti they formed and it is born and then it is growing up vardhate and completely modifications so that's what here defined janma vruddhi birth and growth and parinam the so we are continuing after internet break so we are talking about the six modifications of the body at the body level where asti jayate vardhate and the modifications and apakshiha then deterioration and vinasyati so vardhate and apakshiyate and here after deterioration talk about vyadhi and nashanam so final disease and death all are modifications of the body this is my body idam shariram sharira anything that I can point out has to be an object and I am not that because I am the one who is pointing so anything that is I am knowledgeable cannot be me because knower is different from a known and known is an object inert and knower is the conscious entity and therefore this is vinash see this nashanam bhinam so this destruction is not for I am independent of this that's called pratyagatma I can quote when I was a child child, I did this, this. When I was an adult, I did this. So I am same. Only thing is what I am, identification with the body is continually changing and the mind is changing, intellect is changing. This I am changing, I don't change as I am, but I am changing as this, this, this. So modifications only at the equipment level, but when I take that I am also changing because my equipments are changing, then that's because due to wrong notions of understanding that I am this. Since this is not, I am not this, but I am that which pervades this, if that has clearly understood, therefore this is nasana vihinam. So destruction of the body continuously, that's why the whole Gita Upanishad started, Dehinosmin yatha dehe kaumaram yavvanam jara yatha dehantara praptihi. And therefore, even that, therefore there is no reason for you to cry because you are going to get a better body, because this body is no more useful for or conducive to exhaust the next set of vasanas. Therefore, vasamsa jirnani yatha vihaya. Navani grunhati naroparani. So just as changing the clothes, why should you, do you cry when you change your clothes and getting a new clothes? You are happy to do it because that change, those clothes are useless and become dirty. Therefore, all that janma, vruddhi, parinati and apachaya and vyadhi, all those things are already with that. So it's better to give up that and take up a better body. And if I take myself, I am body, then I start crying, oh, I am getting this problem, I am getting that problem. So whenever this understanding of this meditation means, whenever the body undergoes modifications, knee may be paining, this may be paining, back may be paining, all diseases may be paining, but still I say I am very happy because that's my true nature in spite of the unhappiness at the body level or the mind level or the intellect level. Okay, we are discussing the Jain story. So there was a sage next door and this girl who was a neighbor, she, out of fear to father, she said the father, she became pregnant because of that sage. So the father was so furious, and when the satsang was going on, he came storming there, says, you caused the problem. My daughter mentioned that you are the father of this one, and he abuses left and right. And all the spectators and the people who are listening are very, very surprised. Says, he is teaching something and his behavior is completely different. They also left. And this man accused everything, and when the baby is born, he brought the baby and left it with the sage. This, you are a father, take care of him. So the sage said, is that so? So he took that baby, and since the baby is innocent, so he fed the baby, he got whatever the food he has, he started getting the milk and all that and taking care of the baby. And slowly that girl confessed to her father, he is not the father, somebody else is father, I just said like that. The man was so unhappy, he came running to this sage. So I am very sorry, my daughter said you are not the father, and we are sorry for giving all these troubles, I'll take the baby back. I said, okay, is that so? Take it. So he gave the baby back to the father. And now, what is the attitude of this sage? The sage is, no, this is a prarabdha that he has to go through that experience, it's okay. But he himself was unaffected by the whole thing. People came, they wanted to listen, people left because they got carried away. And if they know, they will come again, if that's their problem, not my problem. So he was reveling in himself by himself. Dukkeshu anudvignamanaha, sukeshu vigatasprahaha, vita raga bhayakrodaha, stitadhiradhinam muniyuchyate. That's what Krishna says. All these ups and downs will go on continuously, but I am essentially all that vihinam. Therefore, this is janma vruddhi parinatya pachaya vyadhinashana vihinam. So none of them really affect me. They are affecting my body, mind and intellect, but I am not the body, mind, intellect. I can be sakshi, witnessing consciousness of what is happening at the body, mind, intellect. And I am avyayam, unchanging, inexhaustible happiness, that is I am. But it's my true nature. Visva srushtya vana ghata karanam So Vishwa Srushti and Avanaghata Karanam. So here it is, I am the cause for the creation, sustenance and dissolution. So I am the Brahmaji, I am the Vishnu, I am the Lord Shiva. Because these are Trimurtis, or each one has a particular portfolio. One is involved in creation, one is in the sustenance, and another one is destruction, because destruction is required to for a new creation. So it is a continuous cycle of Janma Srushti and the Laya. So Srushti Sthiti Laya, and I am the Karanam, because I am the infiniteness from which the whole thing is rising and sustaining and go back, and I am unaffected by this, because these are only superficial, just as the gold is unaffected by forming a ring and a bangle and a necklace and so on. So Vishwa Srushti Avanaghata Karanam, so I am the very cause for the whole creation. Cause means it is both the intelligent cause and the material cause. So they cannot be different, because Brahman being infinite, you cannot have two separate causes. So it is the Nimitta and Upadana Karanam, both are Abhinnam. This is without any difference of that, because it is something same, just as Yathornana Bisrunase Gunnatecha. Also Mundaka Upanishad explains that it is just as the spider putting forth the whole net, or the thread that is coming out, it can absorb back if it wants, or it's poor. So both the Srushti and Laya and Sthiti maintenance, everything is done by the spider. It is just a simple example to illustrate that everything is coming from the whole Brahman, sustained by Brahman. It's both Nimitta Karanam and Upadana Karanam. And that's where Vishwa Srushti Avanaghata Karanam Brahma Tattva Masi Bhavayatmani. So recognize that Brahman is I am. Tam Asi, that you are that Brahman. So it's an instruction to the student that Bhavaya Atmani. Here Atmani means, we said, it is in the Buddhi. So in the Buddhi, I have to recognize that I am the totality, because it is the Buddhi that has misconceptions about itself and about the world also. You go to the next sloka, 260. Astabheda manapastha lakshanam
nistaranga jalarasi nischalam nitya muktam avibhakta murtiyat brahma tattvamasi bhavayatmani. Astabheda manapastha lakshanam nistaranga jalarasi nischalam nitya muktam avibhakta murtiyat brahma tattvamasi bhavayatmani. So atmani in the buddhi, bhavam Bhavaya. So Brahma Tattvam, you are that Brahman, and that is called Astabhedam Anapastha Lakshanam. So Astabhedam. So all Vedas is Astam, means it is gone. That means all Vedas means all differences of every difference that you can. So the whole world is nothing but differences only. In fact, that's what according to the, I thought so, it is a Jiva Jiva Vinnatvam, Jiva Jagat Vinnatvam, and Jagat inside, Jagat Jagat Vinnatvam, Jiva Ishvara Vinnatvam, Jagat Ishvara Vinnatvam. They call it five Vinnas there, and all those Vinnas, also the Vinna is also from the point of Sajati, Vijati, Swagata Vedas, the differences of all those things are also, everything becomes quiet, because they are perceived as not real. Astabheda means, Asti means gone means gone, the reality to that is gone. In spite of that, I can see oneness, just as that I don't see any more differences in the ring and the bangle and necklace. My vision is gold only, so I see everything is nothing but gold only. There is no difference of ring qualities and the bangle qualities and the necklace attributes. They belong to only Vyashti, that is individual object, but from the point of the totality, my vision is changed. Even though I am looking at the ring and the bangle and the necklace, and even though I am using them, and even though I can see differences at the superficial level, I am also seeing that what pervades everything, which doesn't have any of those differences. So all Vedas are Astam, that means they are gone.
Astabedam anapastha lakshanam. So, and anapastha lakshanam. So, itself has no distinctions of any kind, and that is of the nature of pure Sachidananda Lakshanam. Nistaranga jalarasya nischalam. Nistarangam, without any waves, like an ocean without any waves. So waves are property of the ocean, but when I am looking at the waves or the as a water, and looking the ocean also is a water. So from the Ishvara the whole thing is coming out. It is a vibhuti of the Ishvara. Whole 10th chapter is nothing but Krishna saying, so much is my vibhuti. All that is provided, I can look at the vibhuti. Ocean is still different from the wave. Waves are coming from the ocean, sustained by the ocean, they go back into the ocean. But from the point of water, it is a water in the ocean is same as water in the waves, and from the water point there is no difference of any kind. From the point of water H2O, there is neither a ocean nor the waves. So nistaranga jalarasya nischalam. Also, when the mind is now calm and quietened, when agitation less, now the whole Ananda Swarupam is purified, and I am that state in spite of now, whether it's disturbed or not, I am not disturbed anymore. I am now Nistarangam, no waves in that. So in spite of any disturbances, that's what essentially Dukkeshu Anudvigna Manaha Sukeshu Vigatasprahaha. I have no Vita Ragam, therefore there is no Ragas and Dveshas. My mind is calm and quiet in spite of disturbances at the body, mind and intellect level. That's called the Nistaranga Jalarasya Nischalam. Nischalam means unperturbed mentally and emotionally. The sage becomes unperturbed because recognize that I am the Ananda Swarupam itself. He is reveling in himself by himself. It becomes Atmarati and Atmakrida. Nitya Muktam Avibhakta Murtiyatu. I am eternally liberated. Not that I am going to be liberated. I am now realized what? That I was Brahman. I am Brahman. I was ever Brahman. Never I was a Jiva to start with. That is a realization. Not that now from now on I am going to be Brahman. The understanding will be that I was and I am, I shall be, because Brahman cannot undergo any modification or changes, even spite of the changing, but I took the changes as a real, and that's my problem. Now I understood that I am the changeless entity in all the changing things. That's what essentially Nitya Muktam. So Nitya Mukta Swarupoham, I am of the nature of eternal liberation, and Vibhakti Murtiyatu. So there is no Vibhakti, there is no division of any kind, one uniform nature of the Satchidanandam, and that is Brahma Tattva Masi Bhavayatmani. So recognize that I am the nature of that Brahman, and that has to be recognized in the seat of meditation or in understanding in spite of the disturbances at the body, mind and intellect level. There will be disturbances whether I am a Jivan Mukta or not, whether I am a Jnani or not, all other things will be exactly same. Only thing difference is that I have understood these disturbances are